Welcome to our math tutorial. Today we're going to explore the world of fractions. I'll be asking some common questions, and our expert host will help us understand everything from parts and wholes to adding and subtracting like fractions. Ready to dive in? First off, what exactly is a fraction?
Great question. A fraction represents a part of a whole and is made up of two numbers, the numerator on top and the denominator on the bottom. The numerator tells us how many parts we have, while the denominator shows how many equal parts the whole is divided into. For example, if we have a pizza cut into 8 slices and you take 3, the fraction representing your share is 3/8.
Can fractions represent parts of a group or collection too?
Yes, they can. Fractions are not just for a single object. They can also represent parts of a group. For instance, if you have 12 marbles and 4 of them are blue, the fraction of blue marbles is 4/12. This tells us that 4 out of the 12 marbles are blue.
Sometimes different fractions seem to represent the same value. Yeah, what are these called?
Those are called equivalent fractions. They look different, but actually represent the same value. For example, 1/2 is the same as 2/4, 3/6, or 4/8. You can find equivalent fractions by multiplying or dividing both the numerator and the denominator by the same number.
How can we tell if a fraction is in its simplest form?
A fraction is in its simplest form when the numerator and denominator have no common factors other than 1. For example, the fraction 8/12 can be simplified to 2/3 by dividing both the numerator and the denominator by their greatest common divisor, which is 4.
I've heard of like and unlike fractions. You know, what's the difference between them?
Like fractions have the same denominator, such as 1/4 and 3/4, making them easier to work with. Unlike fractions have different denominators, like 1/3 and 2/5, and they need to be converted to like fractions before adding or subtracting them.
What's the difference between proper and improper fractions, and what are mixed numbers?
Good question. A proper fraction has a numerator smaller than the denominator, like 3/5. An improper fraction has a numerator larger than or equal to the denominator, like 7/4. A mixed number combines a whole number with a fraction, like 1/3/4. You can convert a mixed number to an improper fraction, and vice versa.
How do we add or subtract fractions with the same denominator?
Adding and subtracting, like fractions, is straightforward because the denominators are already the same. To add, just add the numerators and keep the denominator unchanged. For example, 2/5 plus 1/5 equals 3/5. To subtract, subtract the numerators. For example, 4/7 minus 2/7 equals 2/7. The denominator remains the same.
What if the fractions have different denominators?
That's when we need to convert unlike fractions to like fractions by finding a common denominator. For example, 1/3 and 2/5 can be converted to 5/15 and 6/15 respectively. Once they have the same denominator, we can easily add or subtract them.
That was really helpful. Today we covered a lot of ground on fractions.
Yes, we did. We talked about parts and wholes, fractions of a collection, equivalent fractions, simplest form, like and unlike fractions, and how to add and subtract like fractions. Remember, practice is key to mastering fractions. So keep practicing and soon you'll be a fraction pro.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more math tutorials. See you next time.